Good afternoon and welcome to Boulos Stadium right here on the campus of Cheverus High School. My name is Russ Thompson, bringing you the broadcast tonight on mbr.org. Want to thank our sponsors for tonight, the Rogers Norton Wealth Management Group of Raymond James Financial, customizing financial plans for individuals, creating endowment-style plans for their families to ensure that they achieve their goals, as well as taking care of future generations. Call them today for a free consultation and financial plan, 771-1800. And are you the next one? T-shirts and apparel.
I am!
Please visit areyouthenextone.com to order your t-shirt today, and also mbr.org, the only place to catch all the action all season long is MBR, Maine's best resource for sports, online at mbr.org. All right, opening game here of the season, we've got Cheverus hosting the Portland Bulldogs. This is a rematch of last year's Eastern Class A final, which went to the Stags 22-19, but that game was really in Portland's favor for the majority of it, up 19-7 at halftime. But the Stags really held the Bulldogs to not much in the second half, and they came out eventually losing in the state championship game to Bonnie Eagle. Portland replaces quite a few really good skill players. Justin Zukowski, who led the SMAA in rushing last year, and Javon Pitts-Young, but they return most of their line, and it's kind of the flip for Cheverus. They return pretty much all of their skill players, but replace a big couple guys up on the line, and most notably returning is Joe Fitzpatrick, who might be the favorite right now to win the Fitzpatrick Trophy here in the state of Maine, which goes to the state's best senior. So he's returning, feisty as ever, and we've got a great matchup here for you right here on mbr.org. Welcome to Boulos Stadium. We've got an action-packed game here, opening kickoff weekend in the state of Maine, and we've got the Cheverus Stags hosting the Portland Bulldogs. This may be a game that decides home field advantage in the playoffs. These two teams met in the Eastern A final last year right here at Boulos Stadium, and it was Cheverus that came from behind and was victorious 22-19. Portland is replacing a couple all-time great players in their program, but they do return a lot of the big guys that block. And Joe Fitzpatrick, who is deep, had 1,400 yards rushing last year. And the kickoff, John Williams with the kick. It's returned by Cheverus from the 9, and a good tackle there. First and 10 at the 23. New quarterback under center. It's a run to the left. LaFontaine with that one. Gain of 4. Second and 6 here at the 27-yard line. Cheverus done under center. And this time it's to Fitzpatrick. Good tackle there by the Portland defense. Down and 7 from their own 26-yard line. Cheverus under center. They might have to go pass here. Doesn't look like it though. Oh, rolling out to the right is done. He's got nobody. He's going to take that one out of bounds. And Cheverus is looking at a fourth down here.
Fourth down.
So fourth and 8. Fitzpatrick is deep. Looks like a punt here.
22, Jacob Knopf. And 42.
The boot by Fitzpatrick.
George Chasen.
And that one will be touched by Cheverus.
Ball will be down to the Portland 44.
First and 10 here for Portland at their own 45-yard line. Good field position here. Talbot under center. He hikes, tosses to the right. And that's Jordan Floridino. Or George Chazon Lapine. Excuse me. Second and 4 at the 49-yard line. Talbot under center. He's got 3 backs in the backfield. And this one goes to the Chason Lapine again, and he's going to get a first down there, gain about 10 yards on the play. So first and 10 at the 39-yard line of Cheverus. Portland driving here. Talbot under center, three in the back. He's going to give it back to Chason Lapine. Not much there. Good tackling by Cheverus. So 9:30 left here in the first quarter. Second and 9 for Portland. Talbot under center. He's got two in the backfield, one out wide and one to his left. He's got an arm. He hikes, gets back, and he's going to throw it. And that's a good catch there by Austin Phillips. That'll get the first down. First and 10 at the 27-yard line. Talbot to Phillips. Beautiful pass there. Chason Lapine is in motion, and they're going to toss it out wide. And that was Cedric Smith who took the handoff. Gained about 2. Second and 7 at the 18-yard line. Talbot under center. He fumbles the snap, but picks it up and takes it forward about 4 yards, almost to the first down there. This game is brought to you by the Rogers Norton Wealth Management Group of Raymond James Financial, customizing financial plans for individuals, creating endowment style plans for their families to ensure that they can achieve their goals, as well as taking care of future generations. Call them today for a free consultation and financial plan, 771-1800. Also brought to you on mbr.org, the only place to catch all the action all season long. Is mbr.org, Maine's best resource for sports, and areyouthenextone.com. First and 10 here, 8 minutes left in the first quarter. Talbot under center, and he's gonna hand that one off, but not much there. Maybe a loss of yards, gulfed up by the Cheverus defense. Second and 10 here. Talbot tosses to Chason Lapine. He's going up the middle, gains about 2 there. Portland in the red zone, Talbot under center. And he's gonna toss to Chason Lapine. He's got blockers, but not enough to get the first down. So Cheverus with a big stop there. So fourth down here. Russ Thompson here on the MBR.org broadcast. Cheverus takes over at their own 17-yard line. The snap done, rolls out to the right. He's gonna toss it up, and that one is intercepted. What a play by Joe Esposito. And there's a penalty on the play after, but just magnificent leap there by Esposito. That's the favorite right now for the Rogers Norton Wealth Management Group Raymond James Financial Play of the Game. Esposito with an incredible interception. So first and 10 for Portland at the Cheverus 14-yard line. Esposito with the interception, and then a personal foul after that. Talbot under center. He's got 3 in the backfield. And there's a penalty. So first and 15 at the 19-yard line for Portland. False start there. Talbot under center. He's got Esposito and Smith in the backfield. 2 to the right. He's gonna hand this one off to Esposito. And he rumbles to the left for a gain of about 2. Second and 14, Talbot under center. He's got Smith in motion, or Esposito in motion. He throws it to Smith. Good block there. Holman absolutely pancaking Esposito right there. 15 here, passing down, you would assume. Jordan Talbot under center. He's got an arm. 3 to his left, 2 in the backfield. All right, so third and 15 here, passing down. You would assume Talbot has got an arm, and he's got 2 to his left, Smith. And Phillips, Talbot hikes, rolls out to his left, and he's gonna throw in the back of the end zone. Oh, and just out of the reach of Esposito. That was, or actually Phillips there. That was almost a really beautiful pass. Fourth down here, John Williams in to try and kick another field goal. He missed his first one from about this distance. The snap, the hold is good. And this time it is good for John Williams. So Portland jumps ahead 3-0 with 4:17 left in the first quarter right here on MBR.org. Back here to Boulos Stadium. John Williams just kicked a field goal and he's gonna have the duties of kickoff right here. That one's kicked over into Fitzpatrick's and he takes it. Joe Fitzpatrick. And he's still on his feet, but now he gets wrapped up at about the 30-yard line. And here at the 31-yard line, Dunn under center. And he hands it off. Up the middle, that's Fitzpatrick. He gets about five. So second and six. This one goes to Fitzpatrick out of the backfield. He tries to break a couple tackles, but gets wrapped up. It looks like for a loss there. So third and eight here. Third and long. Two wide receivers split out wide. And Dunn's gonna take the snap. And it's a good pass. Completed, and he breaks a tackle. That is Kenny Drellich with the reception. Big gain there. First down. So first and 10 at the Portland 43-yard line. Only one back, and it's Fitzpatrick, and he takes it right up the gut. Breaks a tackle, and that's about first down territory right there, and a flag comes in late. So a 5-yard penalty for a face mask there. First and 10 at the 38-yard line for Cheverus. Dunn under center, he's got, hands that one off up the middle to the fullback. Justin Johnson there on the carry. So second and 5 at the 24-yard line. The handoff to Fitzpatrick, he goes right up the middle and gains about 5 on that one, maybe 6. Running right up the middle right now is Cheverus. So first and 10 at the 18-yard line for Cheverus, marching down the field. Dunn snaps, tries to make, and he's gonna get a tackle for a loss there. About 5 yards, had to roll out to his left, but nothing was there. 30 seconds left in the first quarter, 3-0, Portland up on top of Cheverus. Second and 16 here for the Stags. And the handoff is to Fitzpatrick, and he breaks a couple tackles, and he's gonna take this one in for a touchdown. Beautiful run there by Fitzpatrick, eluding Portland defenders, and that's gotta be a nominee for the Rogers Norton Wealth Management Group of Raymond James Financial Play of the Game. Taking that one for about 25 yards to the house is Joe Fitzpatrick. That just shows you how special he is. So Patrick Moriamis coming on for the kick. He's almost automatic. And that one is good. So we've got it 7-3 Cheverus with 21.7 seconds left here in the first quarter right here on MBR.org. All right, welcome back here on the MBR.org broadcast. Russ Thompson here with you, 7-3 Cheverus with 20 seconds left in the first quarter. Joe Fitzpatrick just with an amazing run, 25 yards to the house. So kicking off is Cheverus. Holman boots that one way up into the air. It looks like Chason Lapine, and he's gonna get tackled right away by Cheverus. Good coverage there from the special teams. So first and 10 at their own 23 is Portland, trailing 7-3. Talbot under center. He's gonna take this one himself. No gain. And that'll be the end of the first quarter, 7-3. Cheverus up on top of Portland. This game is brought to you by Are You the Next One? T-shirts and apparel. With hard work, focus, and determination, you can be the next great player. Please visit areyouthenextone.com to order your t-shirt today. areyouthenextone.com. Welcome back. Second quarter kicking off here. Portland at their own 23-yard line. Second down and 10. They trail 7-3. He's going to take this one for the pass. A beautiful pass there by Talbot. That's good for about 10 right there. Should be a first down. Third down and one after that 9 yard Floridino catch. So big down here for the Bulldogs. And they hand it up the middle. And we'll see if they get the first down here. Very close.
First and 10 for the Bulldogs.
First down for Portland. They trail 7-3 with 11 minutes left in the second quarter. Talbot with a couple really nice passes here. He hikes, hands off in the backfield. That's Esposito who fights his way for about five there, maybe six. So second and four for Portland. Talbot's got two in the backfield. He hikes, takes a couple steps back, rolls out to his left. He's gonna take this one himself for the first down. Looks like he got it. So first down for Portland at their own 44 yard line. Talbot under center. Crowded backfield, Smith in motion. This one's handed off. And breaking a tackle is Ryan Rulin. That one for about eight. Second down and three after Esposito's 7 yard run. Talbot takes this one himself. Tries to go down the left hand side, but he'll get knocked out of bounds short of the first down. Look to Talbot, maybe hooking up with Phillips on the outside. Talbot eludes one. He's got a ton of Cheverus. He's still on his feet. That's a high block there. Talbot lets it go. And he's wide open. But this one should be coming back. Ryan Rulin. So we'll replay third down here, offsetting penalties, a block in the back on Portland, but a face mask on Cheverus, and Talbot showing you his athleticism there to elude about four Cheverus stags, but it's third down and eight again. And it's gonna be another false start on Portland, so that's back-to-back downs there. False starts on Portland. In between that was offsetting penalties. So fourth time around here for third down for the Bulldogs. Third and 13. Talbot rolls back to his left. And that one is low. So the Bulldogs are going to have to punt here. Good stop by the Cheverus defense. Talbot's deep to punt. And he can't take that one. So Cheverus will take over in great field position at the Portland 32-yard line. Talbot not happy with that. So first and 10 at the 33-yard line.
Camera.
And that one will be taken up the gut. A gain of about five by Fitzpatrick. Second down and six. At the 29 for Cheverus. Dunn snaps, hands off to Fitzpatrick. He's eluding tacklers, keeps his feet moving. And that'll be a gain of about four or five. We'll see if he gets the first down. So first down and 10, Dunn under center, Fontaine in motion, Fitzpatrick deep in the backfield, but this one will be handed off to Jacob Scott. Second down and about 10 right here. Handing off inside to Fontaine. He breaks a couple tackles, but he'll get wrapped up at about the 18-yard line. So third down and six, big play here. Dunn shotgun, he rolls out to his right. Cedric Smith chasing. Dunn breaks one tackle, but he won't get the first down. It'll be fourth down and about two. For Cheverus, looks like they're gonna go for it. 4 yards to go, Dunn under center. He hands it off, going the opposite way. He's going to go in. That's Liam LaFontaine, untouched. Cheverus goes up 13-3 on the end around. LaFontaine with a nice run there. And Cheverus gets on the board again. The snap, hold.
Nice kick.
And this one is good from Mariamis. 14-3, 5:29 left in the second quarter. Cheverus up on top of Portland, 14 straight points for the Stags. Getting ready to kick it off is Zordon Holman for Cheverus. They're up 14-3. And he boots this one deep. And Smith picks it up, runs back to the left, and takes it out just over the 20-yard line. So Portland first and 10 at their own 20-yard line. Talbot hands this one off to the left to Smith, waiting for his blocking, but Cheverus was all over that one, tackles it in the backfield for a loss. 5 minutes left here in the second quarter, second and 12 for the Bulldogs. Talbot snaps. And that one's taken right up the middle by Esposito. Gaines about 8 or 9 there. So third down and 5. Talbot under center, 3 in the backfield. He takes that one himself. It looked like another fumble there that Talbot had to pick up. So 4th and 6, Talbot deep to punt. No man deep for Cheverus. And this one's going to be recovered by Esposito at the Cheverus 37-yard line. Over with all the momentum here, 14 straight points, just over 3 minutes left in the first half at their own 37-yard line. Dunn snaps, LaFontaine in motion. He's going to drop back and make the pass to Drelich. Oh, right out of the hands of Kenny Drelich. So Dunn under center here, second down and 10. This time he's going to hand off to Fitzpatrick. Looking to break a couple tackles, but that time he's wrapped up by Dominic DeMillo. So first and 10 for Cheverus, just over 3 minutes left in the first half. They're looking to get back on the board. Dunn snaps, he's going to throw this one, looking for Drelich. And that one, oh, what a catch by Kenny Drelich. Fantastic. That one will be another nominee for the Rogers Norton Wealth Management Group of Raymond James Financial Play of the Game. Drelich went way up into the air and was tackled in the process by Esposito, but still held on for the ball. So Cheverus driving down the field here very quickly. And this one's handed off to Fitzpatrick on first down, and he's wrapped up after a gain of about 2. Down in 10, clock ticking, 2 minutes left here in the first half. Dunn under center. He's gonna roll out and toss this one deep, but out of the reach of LaFontaine. Good coverage there by Chazon Lapine. Third down and 9 here from the 23-yard line. Dunn in the shotgun. He's got Drelich and Holman to his left. He's going to roll out to the right, put this one up in the air, and a good play there, right as contact was happening. LaFontaine trying to make that catch. So fourth down and 9, and Cheverus is going to go for it, Dunn in the shotgun. He's got 3 out to his left. The snap, he rolls out to his left. He slips, eludes a tackle. Another one, Dunn still on his feet, and he's going to try and take this one for the first down, and there's a penalty on the flag. So block in the back there on Cheverus. That penalty was declined, so turnover on downs. Portland takes over. Big stop there by the Bulldog defense. Talbot snaps, drops back, passes the outside. Good pass is caught. Gain of about 7 there. So 1 minute left in the game, clock ticking. Second down and 2. Talbot loses that one, fumble. And it's going to be recovered by Cheverus. So they take over in great field position there, and Cheverus takes over with 55 seconds left in great field position. Dunn takes a snap. He rolls out off his back foot, and that's Cedrelic, and another incomplete. That was a big hit there. So Drellick might got the wind knocked out of him there. Two defenders coming in to make the tackle. So it's second and 10, Dunn under center. He's got LaFontaine in motion and Fitzpatrick in the backfield. And this one is gonna go to Fitzpatrick. He's gonna take it up about 8 yards, close to the first down. So third down and four, 40 seconds left, 14-3, Cheverus up over Portland. Dunn in the shotgun, he takes the snap, rolls back, passes this one out wide and out of the hands of Johnson. Now, so another fourth down here for Cheverus just before halftime, and they're gonna change up the formation, but Portland, Dunn hands off to Fitzpatrick. Can he get it? He eludes a couple tackles. He's, that's gonna be a first down, and he gets wrapped up. Dunn just spikes that one to stop the clock. 25 seconds left, second down and 10 from the 20-yard line. And this one's handed off up the middle. LaFontaine, he's gonna take it in for the score. Touchdown, Cheverus. Liam LaFontaine. And here for the kick. Moriamas, and that one is right down the middle. 21-3, 20 seconds left. Cheverus scores again. That is 21 straight points. You're listening and watching right here on MBR.org. I'm Russ Thompson, bringing you the coverage. The only place to catch all the action all season long is MBR, Maine's best resource for sports, and online at MBR.org. Also by Are You the Next One t-shirts and apparel. With hard work, focus, and determination, you can be the next great player. Are you the next one? And that's a little squib kick. And he's just gonna dive on it. That is Charles Kovarik. So first down and 10, 17 seconds left here. Talbot's gonna have to look deep. He takes a snap and shotgun, throws it out deep, and that one is out of the hands of Austin Phillips. So Talbot takes a snap, throws out wide. That one's caught, eluding one tackle. Still on his feet, but wrapped up. That was Floridino, Jordan Floridino. And spiking it. So one last chance here, more than likely. Talbot takes a snap. Takes it right up the middle. And that'll bring us to the end of the first half. 21-3, Cheverus. All right, welcomed here by Michael Hoffer of The Forecaster. You can follow him on Twitter at @4sports. Michael, seemed like Portland came out of here, had a couple chances there on, but a little bit of nerves and jitters from the Bulldogs.
Well, you know, I was really impressed with how they moved the ball the first couple drives. They really had Cheverus on their heels. I think Portland's line really was pushing Cheverus back, and I know that's the one real question mark about the Stags this year is their line play. So Portland had a couple great opportunities to get an early touchdown on the board. The first time they turned the ball over on downs, or they missed the field goal. The second time they made the field goal. But Cheverus doesn't kick field goals. They score touchdowns. And you could see once they got their offense going, they just needed a spark. And it turned out to be the guy who was the hero in last year's regional final. Kenny Drelick made that nice catch, broke the tackle, had the long gainer. And that kind of got him going. Joe Fitzpatrick had only 5 yards on his first four carries, and then he started to get it going too. And you can just see that Cheverus' confidence has grown and grown. And now Portland's really reeling, especially that score right before halftime really puts them on the ropes.
Yeah, Portland with a couple false starts there, but Cheverus was pretty flawless. You talked about Fitzpatrick, his run, and LaFontaine's, both of his runs were completely untouched there, so great blocking from the Stags.
Yeah, and then the last one coming on a fourth down, you know, you'd expect at least some opposition on a play like that. But Portland's shooting themselves in the foot. They have 6 penalties for 40 yards. Yes, it's a first game. They've had several snaps that have been botched.
Right.
One finally turned into a turnover. So really, they've got no one to blame but themselves. I don't know that Cheverus is necessarily 18 points better at this point. It's just what Portland's doing to themselves.
Yeah, it's kind of a flip of what happened here last year where Portland came out in the second quarter and took charge. It was Cheverus today that really took charge of this game.
Yeah, and I know there are some different faces in different places, but this is still Cheverus. They've, for the last 4 or 5 years, there's been, pretty much no competition for them. I mean, they've been the gold standard. They feel like they're still the team to beat. They've beaten Portland 6 times in a row over the last 4 years, and that's tough. When you're on the other side of that, you can talk about this is our turn, but until you actually go out and do it, it's all talk. And, Cheverus just has that mental advantage that they know what to do at crunch time, and they don't hurt themselves generally, and that's been the case so far in the first half.
Do you think for the Bulldogs it's a case of replacing too many stars? I mean, Talbot, you can see his athleticism out there, but it seems like he's got a little too much on his plate right now.
Well, I mean, you look at what they lost in Justin Zukowski.
Yeah.
He was obviously a huge part of the offense, and he was a big player on defense, too. And they don't have his production. Yeah, Talbot's athleticism is terrific. He can make things happen. That play where he eluded the sack and threw down the field for the long gainer that was negated, unfortunately, just shows you what he can do. And Portland does have some weapons. Some kids are starting to make some names for themselves. But it's going to be a process, and it's going to be a case of you've got to play smart football. You can't turn it over. You can't take penalties. And to compete with a team like Cheverus, you got to play close to a perfect game, and they're not doing it.
And lastly, Wolf Graham, obviously, he's got his legendary tradition of playing with a triple option. But Dunn, the new quarterback, seems like he has a little bit more of a traditional arm for a quarterback. Do you expect them to do a little bit more in the passing game throughout the season?
Yeah, I mean, you're never going to see Cheverus spread the field and throw the ball 50 times. That's just not who they are. I mean, they're a team, they line up, they're going to say, here's what we're going to do to stop us.
Especially with Fitzpatrick back there.
And why wouldn't you give the ball to him 30 times a game if you can? But it's nice to have that option. And you can see they don't hesitate to go to the air if they have to, and not necessarily on third down and long. They'll go to the air on other situations. Dunn is very impressive. He was the JV quarterback last year. He saw very limited varsity time. So for this really to be his first varsity game, you got to admire how he's played so far. He does have a nice arm, and they do have that facet of their offense that's going to keep the other team on their toes.
All right, this is Michael Hoffer. Make sure you follow 4Sports on Twitter and also read the game recap in the Forecaster. I'm Russ Thompson, 21-3 at halftime. Cheverus up over Portland right here on MBR.org. Second half, Cheverus up on top of Portland, 21-3. 21 straight points by the Stags. Holman about set to kick off here. He boots this one deep into the end zone, and that one will go out for a touchback. First and 10 here. And another fumble there. This one looks like it's recovered by Portland. Second down and 13. Talbot from the shotgun takes a snap, looks to his left, fires. That one is out of the hands of LaFountain. Almost another interception there by the Cheverus Stags. So third and long for the Bulldogs here. Talbot under center and a flag here. So third down and 19, a false start on the Bulldogs. Talbot drops back and throws that one deep up into the air. Coming back for it, making the catch, is Austin Phillips. That one was lobbed way up into the air. It looked like LaFountain was going to get there, but at the last second, Phillips comes in. That is a big gain there for the Bulldogs. Big play for the Bulldogs. First and 10 at the 45-yard line. The handoff up the middle is gobbled up. Number 90, Zordon Holman, was there for the tackle. So second and 9, 10 and a half left here in the third quarter. Cheverus up on top 21-3, but Portland is driving. Talbot rolls out to his left. He's going to take this one himself, but nothing there. A loss. So third down and 12 for the Bulldogs. Another third and long. Talbot drops back to his left. He's chased, puts that one up in the air, and it's out of the reach. Fourth down coming here for the Bulldogs. Fourth down here, Talbot back deep. He punts this one Good punt there. Fair catch given. And the Stags will take over on the 20-yard line. Cheverus takes over the ball. They have scored 21 straight points. Look very comfortable on offense. New quarterback this year, Isaac Dunn under center. He's going to hand this one off to the left. Untouched here is Justin Johnson. Breaks a tackle and gets it over the 40-yard line. That is a gain of 20 yards. Johnson knocking on the door, the Raymond James play of the game there. He's got a couple fellow teammates, LaFountain and Fitzpatrick, in contention, but that was a big play there. Moves the chains for the Stags. First and 10 from the 40-yard line from the Stags. This one again to Johnson, but this time he gets wrapped up in the backfield for a loss. So clock ticking, just over 8 minutes left in the third quarter. Second and 11. Dunn hands off to Fitzpatrick right up the middle. He gets gobbled up after about 4 yards on that play. So gonna be third down and 8 here. The third quarter. Cheverus driving here. Big third down for the Bulldogs. Can they stop the Stags? Dunn under center. He's going to hand this one off to Fitzpatrick down the left, looking for his blocking, breaks one right there, and chased out of bounds short of the first down. In the punt formation, Portland's got two deep. Fitzpatrick to punt. That's a low snap. Fitzpatrick can't get on it. He's just going to have to jump on that. Tries to pick it up, does, and breaks one tackle, takes him right down, but still a loss of quite a bit there. Play there, Portland takes over in very favorable field position. Whistle here and a penalty. So no play there, so still first down and 10, 7 minutes left in the third quarter. Cheverus up on top, 21-3. Talbot hands this one off to Chason Lapine. He's got some blocking there. Takes it up to about the 20-yard line. Gain of about 4 there. Second down and about 6 here at the 20-yard line. Talbot under center, he's got two backs to his left. One spread out wide and another fumble there. Problems between the center and Talbot all game long. Third down. So third down and 10, 6:15 left, Talbot under center. Hands this one off and nothing there. So fourth and 10, they're going for it. Talbot under center. Drops to his left. Holman pressuring. Talbot launches that one up into the air and knocked down. Good play there by LaFountain. Intended receiver Austin Phillips, but that will be a turnover on downs. Cheverus will take over. First and 10 at the 27-yard line for Cheverus. Dunn hands it off. That's Johnson. He'll take it about 3 to set up a second and 7. Second and 7. Under 5 here in the third quarter. Dunn hands this one off to Fitzpatrick. Breaks a couple tackles, still on his feet. And he takes it over to the 42-yard line. First down for the Stags. Dunn, under center. He hands this one off. Fitzpatrick, or no, it's Johnson actually, still on his feet. He's going to take this one to the house, breaking tackles. Justin Johnson, big play. That one goes for 55 yards, and I think we have a leader in the clubhouse for the Raymond James play of the game, brought to you by the Rogers Norton Wealth Management Group of Raymond James. That was pretty impressive there by Johnson, taking that one to the house, and now Cheverus is up 27-3 with 4 minutes left here in the third quarter. Watch out, guys. And the kick is good. So that's 28-3, 4:09 left here in the third quarter. Cheverus opening up some space. Touchdowns for LaFountain with 2, Fitzpatrick with 1, And just as you just saw Justin Johnson there, from about 55 yards out to the house. Welcome back here, Russ Thompson on MBR.org. 28-3, Cheverus up on top, Zarden Holman to kick off. This one, a high booming kick. It's gonna be bobbled there, but picked up. That's Floridino, and he's gonna get it just out to about the 13 yard, right there. So the Bulldogs take over at the 13 yard line. They've got to get something going here, down 28-3. Talbot hands that one off to the left. Esposito trying to make a couple miss, but he'll get wrapped up, a gain of about two there on first down. Second and 14, Talbot under center. He drops back, passes the outside. That's Floridino, good catch there for the first down. That one good for about 20, brings it all the way out past the 30 yard line. So first and 10 at the 31 for the Bulldogs. Talbot hands this one off the middle, and that one is nothing there for the Bulldogs. Second and 10, 2 minutes left in the third quarter. Portland needs to put up points in a hurry. Talbot out of the shotgun, he's got two to his right, one to his left. He's gonna pass to Floridini, the screen, trying to break tackles there, still on his feet, but not much, gobbled up by the Cheverus defense there. Third down and 8. Bulldogs trying to drive down the field here. Talbot rolls out to his left. Good blocking there. Just overthrows Esposito to the outside. Punting, we'll see though. And he passes it out, and that's a great ball there, but even better coverage there by Cheverus. That was Fritz Gemmer on the coverage. First down and 10, done under center. He's gonna hand this one off to Fitzpatrick, breaks one tackle, breaks two tackles. Oh my God, Fitzpatrick running with authority. So second and 7, 3 yards there by Fitzpatrick, but three broken tackles, so. Done under center, LaFountain in motion. This one's gonna go back to Fitzpatrick, right up the middle. He's gonna get the first down. Breaks one tackle there, gets into the backfield. Clock ticking under a minute left here in the third quarter. Cheverus is driving. So first and 10 here for Cheverus. Up the middle to Johnson, but he tripped. Won't get much on that one. This game is brought to you by Are You the Next One t-shirts and apparel. With hard work, focus, and determination, you can be the next great player. Please visit areyouthenextone.com to order your t-shirt today. areyouthenextone.com. After three periods of play, it's 28-3, Cheverus all over Portland. Four straight touchdowns for the Stags. To the fourth quarter we go right here on mbr.org. Action starting here, Cheverus taking over at the 20-yard line. The handoff to Fitzpatrick down the left, and he's going to get wrapped up. It's just started raining here at Boulos Stadium, really hot and muggy affair early on, but now the players are going to have to deal with that added element of rain. Doesn't seem to be slowing down the Cheverus offense. This is 3rd and 5. And this one will be taken by LaFountain, and he twirls and breaks a tackle, gets into the second level. So Dunn under center, first down and 10. He hands this one off, Fitzpatrick, right up the middle. And he'll take that one for about 4. Second down and goal, for the Stags. And they hand it off the toss to Fitzpatrick. He makes one miss, takes it to the outside, and dives into the touchdown, and it's good. Touchdown Cheverus, that's another nominee for the Rogers Norton Wealth Management Group of Raymond James Financial Play of the Game. Fitzpatrick puts a second one on the board, a lot like his first one, but the leap there might give him the edge. Once again, that's the Rogers Norton Wealth Management group of Raymond James Financial Play of the Game. And right now, the front runner has got to be Joe Fitzpatrick, but it's fumbled there. Well, Fountain picks it up. Portland is going to try, but this ball is dead, and that was a little bit late after the play. 34-3 Stags. Holman with the kick. Booming kick picked up by Floridini. Breaks one tackle, but gets wrapped up at the 23-yard line. First and 10, fourth quarter action here. 9:43 left in the game. 34-3 Cheverus on top. Talbot takes the snap, throws it. A good one-handed catch there by Shazan Lapine, and he gets wrapped up, but he'll get the first down there. 42. First and 10, Talbot in the shotgun. He's got two to his right, high snap. He gets this one off to Floridini, but he's wrapped up in the backfield. So personal foul there on Cheverus, moves the ball 15 yards, first and 10 for the Bulldogs. Talbot in the shotgun, high snap again, but he gets it. And a long pass, and that one just out of the reach of Austin Phillips. Good throw there from Talbot. Second and 10, not much time on the play clock. Shotgun, Talbot gets it off. And he throws that one just out of the reach of Esposito. Third down and 10. Talbot under center, two in the backfield, one in motion, two outright. Talbot rolls to his right, eludes one tackler. He's coming back to the left. There's three. Holman chasing, and Talbot's still on his feet. He's going to take that one down, still on his feet, all the way to the 25-yard line. So that one came back. A long play there by Talbot, blocking the back. So third down and long for the Stags here. Shotgun, Talbot takes a snap. He's got to lob that one over to the right. Esposito's over there, just out of the reach of him. Good coverage on the far side by Fritz Gemmer. Talbot back to punt, boots that one down. Nobody back deep for Cheverus. Bouncing, and it'll get downed at the 25-yard line. So first and 10 for the Stags. Isaac Dunn hands it off. That's Fitzpatrick going out to the left, breaks a tackle, still on his feet, and he stumbles on his own, but gets it out to about the 45-yard line. Clock ticking, under 8 minutes left here. 34-3, all Stags. They have the ball. Isaac Dunn under center. He's got a couple in the backfield there. This one's going to Johnston, and he takes it up for 5 yards up the middle. Second and 5 for the Stags. Dunn takes a snap again to Johnston. On the left, he's got the first down as he gets tackled out of bounds. And here's Fitzpatrick down the right-hand side, breaking a couple tackles, taking it back to the left. He's still on his feet and all the way down to the 18-yard line. In here, clock ticking, 6:40 left, 34-3. Cheverus driving here. Dunn hands it off to Johnston, but he gets wrapped up right after for no gain. Second and 10, Dunn hands off up the middle. Nothing there. Third down and 10, just over 5 left in the game. Cheverus hands this one off, right up the middle, but nothing there. That was to Ryan Benedict on the carry. Rylan Benedict.
The ball.
Fourth down and 8. Dunn hands this one off to LaFontaine down the left. And he's trying, fighting for that first down. And he could have it there. Looks like he does, first down Stags. And that was just close of the first down. They brought the chain gang out, but we're not there. You're listening to MBR.org, the only place to catch all the action all season long is MBR, Maine's best resource for sports, online at MBR.org. Talbot hands this one off to the inside, but nothing there, gulfed up by Cheverus.
Number 54, Matt Curley.
Second and 7 for the Bulldogs. 3:30 left in the game. Talbot gets back, eludes, but he's chased down, and the ball's a fumble, and it's a touchdown for Cheverus. They jump on the ball. And that was Zordon Holman with the return fumble recovery there, so it's 40-3 Cheverus, 40 straight points over the Bulldogs, 3:27 left. Another nominee for the Rogers Norton Wealth Management Group of Raymond James Financial Play of the Game. And here for the kick is Moriamas. Pat. It's up and it's good. 41-3, 3:27 all Stags here on MBR.org. 3:27 left. Holman, who just recovered a fumble in the end zone, kicks this one off, and it's low. It's jumped on by Portland at about the 29-yard line. First and 10, 3:25 left. Talbot under center. Looks like he might be limping a little bit. Hands this one off. Actually keeps it himself. Still breaking tackle after tackle, and he's tackled by about 5 Stags there. Nothing there. Second and 12. And the toss to Chason Lapine. He breaks a couple tackles and brings it down to the 36-yard line. Looks to be
now ball carrier.
Third down and 4. Nicholas Archambault in the game now. Talbot on the sidelines. And he tosses this one to George Chason Lapine, and he gets it up for the first down, it looks like. 1:30 to left, 41-3, 41 straight points for Cheverus, and it's Archambault under center. There's gonna be a fumble there, but quickly getting on top of it is Jacob Knopp. First and 10, 45 seconds left in the game. The handoff up the middle, nothing there.
Okay, Russ.
Okay. And that'll do it here. 41-3 is your final. Cheverus improves to 1-0 on the year. Portland falls to 0-1 on the year. Want to thank our sponsors for today, the Rogers Norton Wealth Management Group of Raymond James Financial. A couple of play of the games to go through. We'll give it to Joe Fitzpatrick on his 25-yard scamper for the touchdown, but want to throw in Liam LaFountain. He had 2 touchdowns in there as well. Kenny Drellick with a nice catch. And also Justin Johnson with a 55-yard touchdown run. The Rogers Norton Wealth Management Group, customizing financial plans for individuals, creating endowment-style plans for their families to ensure that they can achieve their goals as well as taking care of future generations. Call them today for a free consultation and financial plan if you are thinking about your financial plans at 771-1800. Also want to thank MBR.org, the only place to catch all the action all season long is MBR, Maine's best resource for sports, online at MBR.org. Are you the next one? T-shirts and apparel with hard work, focus, and determination. You can be the next great player. Please visit areyouthenextone.com to order your t-shirt today. Are you the next one? What? So 41-3, the finishing score line today. Not much going well for Portland. They came out, scored the first 3 points of the game on a field goal, but since then it was all Cheverus. Wouldn't be surprised if we see a rematch of these two teams here later on in November like we did last year. Portland lost two games last year, both to Cheverus, and today they were uncharacteristically sloppy, face penalties on face guards and also false starts. Talbot, a couple fumbles in there, but you have to give credit to Cheverus. They came and they were ready to play. Two touchdowns by Joe Fitzpatrick, an early favorite for the Fitzpatrick Trophy here in the state of Maine. Liam LaFountain as well with two touchdowns, Justin Johnson with a 55-yard touchdown run, and Jordan Holman with a fumble recovery here at the end. All right, that'll do it for myself, Russ Thompson, for Joe Carpini, my cameraman and producer. You've been listening and watching to this right here on MBR.org.
All aboard MBR.org, the place to get all your high school and amateur sports news and information. MBR.org is in high gear with Maine high school winter sports. Go to MBR.org to chat about your favorite team, find the latest articles, travel news, and cancellations, or visit their all-new and very popular team pages. MBR.org has everything you want to know about high school and amateur sports in Maine. Coming in February, all the high school tournament action at your fingertips 24/7. It's high school sports heaven. All aboard MBR.org.
Oh, my wedding video!
Never lose your memories to deteriorating VHS tapes by having digital video magic convert them to DVD today.
I am so glad I went to Digital Video Magic and had all of my VHS tapes converted to DVD.
Preserve your memories forever. Call Digital Video Magic now before it's too late.